Allah said, I will provide the disbelieving children also, then I will drag him into hellfire. Do you think Ibrahim alayhi salam likes this response? That some of his kids will end up in the hellfire and they will be in kufr? There will be some that will be in kufr, so he wants to make sure that some will never fall into kufr. So he makes a two-part dua. He first begins with himself and his son. رَبَّنَا وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكْ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكْ. Oh Allah, at least make sure we two, myself and who's building the house with him? Ismail alayhi salam. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ. So Ismail, and he, at least make sure we're two, both of us are Muslim before you, we're in complete submission before you, and make sure that from our future generations, at least there's one group that stays Muslim only for you, that stays in submission only to you. وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا, and show us our rituals and accept our tawbah. Okay. Now this dua is followed up by another dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. He knows that future generations will only remain Muslim. You know, the only way to stay Muslim, if they're going to be kuffar and Muslims together, Islam will deteriorate unless you send someone who makes sure Islam remains pure. So in his genius, he asked, رَبَّنَا وَابْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ. Immediately after that, he asked, oh Allah, send a messenger from among themselves. Appoint one, raise one among them who is a messenger among themselves. So the unworthy are the disbelieving, and the worthy are the believing. And the leader of the worthy will be a messenger. Isn't that true? Now come to the end of Qur'an. But then Allah says these beautiful two things. This is three ayah surah. It's a very short surah, Surah Al-Kawthar, right? The second ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. Pray to your master and sacrifice. Prayer and sacrifice. Whose legacy is that? Ibrahim alayhi salam. Prayer and sacrifice. Because that tradition of sacrifice started with who? Ibrahim alayhi salam, with Ismail, that entire incident with Ismail. So he's being told, you now revive the legacy of your father Ibrahim. Ibrahim alayhi salam, his legacy amounts to one thing, the uniqueness, the oneness of Allah, trusting only Him, relying only upon Him, believing only Him, asking only Him. That's his legacy. That's the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. So we're reminded of the agenda of the ummah. Once again, once this conflict is guaranteed victory, what is the next surah? قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ. What's the purpose of the surah? What's the agenda of the surah? Tawheed. Which in summary is the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Now, this tawheed, is this the first time tawheed was revealed, by the way? No. Every single messenger in history was given tawheed. The same message of the oneness, uniqueness, the unparalleled oneness of Allah Azza wa Jal was the crux of every messenger's message. But is it the case that in human history, Tawheed came and people believed in it, but over time it started getting weaker and weaker and fell into shirk again and got corrupted and deteriorated? Is that the case in human history? Absolutely. Because this is not the first time it happened. People were believers before, but over generations it starts getting weaker and weaker and weaker, and people fall back into shirk. This certainly does happen. Now because this happens, not only did Allah send Tawheed, Allah sent two guardians of Tawheed. You see, the idea is Tawheed can get corrupted from outside influences. And Tawheed can also get corrupted. This Iman in Allah can also be corrupted from inside temptations and influences. So there are negative influences on the outside and there are negative influences on the inside. The negative influences on the outside, Allah sent a guardian against them. That's Surah Al-Falaq. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ, and so on. This surah is dedicated to protecting the believer from corruption and evil influence from the outside. But what's the evil influence on the inside? It's the waswasa of shaitan, right? It's the nafs. It's the bad company that can whisper something into your ear and you say, yeah, this is a good idea. And you first fall into corrupt behavior. Eventually it ruins your tawheed, your iman in Allah altogether. So the corruption of the inside is guarded against in Surah An-Nas. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ. So tawheed and its two guardians, one from corruption of the outside, the other from corruption of the inside. Thus culminating this series of beautiful surahs, these last 10 surahs of the Qur'an. We recite them all the time, but they present such a profound, cohesive argument tied to the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and showing how the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam is connected to the legacy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The last thing I will share with you is Allah's instruction to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and this ayah that I'm going to recite to you or show you part of is the ayah that shows us that Allah is telling the Messenger to revive the legacy of Ibrahim. فَاتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Allah tells the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, make sure you follow the legacy of Ibrahim, حَنِيفًا, who was solely dedicated to Allah. Solely dedicated to Allah Azza wa Jal. So this was the overview that I wanted to spend time sharing with you today.